share a little bit of his testimony with us. My friend, Brother Howard Forman, he has lived abroad for maybe longer than we think in Jamaica, but there might be some people who will remember that he used to sing in a market. Few people might remember that. He's a good singer and a great supporter. Great supporter. He has been, I don't know what he saw, but he has been a great supporter of me from long before I was even a minister. Just a very old friend. And I'm always happy to see him. He's still a great supporter of the Grace Workshop Ministry. Great supporter. Just helping us out in many areas. And I'm going to ask Howard to come to just share his testimony with us. Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise
the Lord again.
Praise
the Lord. I want to thank my good friend, Brother John Mark. I remember about 30 something years ago, while I was saved, you know, I was what you call a holy roller. I was one of those holier than thou individuals. I remember when Brother John Mark got saved, and I was one of the people that encouraged him to walk for God. I was one of the people that testified to him about the grace of God. In those times, Sister Lisa didn't even know that her husband came, that God has brought him. But it's a privilege to be here today. I came to Brother John Mark last week, and I told him that the Lord has placed on my heart to speak with somebody who is in the mode of backsliding at this point. I'm here to speak with somebody who has been going through some stuff for a time, and don't know where to go at this point. I'm here to speak to somebody who might have fell along the way and is not being encouraged to stand up and live for Christ, even in that state of despair and lack of hope. I'll tell you a short story. Once upon a time, I stood outside the windows of Wilder Street Pentecostal Church, and I peeked inside and I saw that something special was going on inside there. My heart hungered for whatever it was. I didn't know the Holy Ghost yet, know nothing about the Holy Ghost, but my heart hungered for what I saw on the inside. And so I went inside, and the Lord baptized me with the Holy Ghost. The Lord filled me, jam-packed me with the Holy Ghost. I remember that in the front row, I sat there, and when God was done with me, none of the chairs was left there. God used me to wipe the floor. And a lot of you here, you remember that moment. I remember I went home that night speaking in another tongue as the Lord gave me utterance. I spoke for 4 days. Hallelujah. I remember that I walked and I preached on the buses. I remember that there was a ferry that used to go to Port Royal. Don't know if it happens anymore, but I remember every Saturday I used to go on that ferry and I used to preach. I was full with fire. I was full with the Holy Ghost. I hated sin. I rejected sin. And I loved God. I had a passion for God. And so neighborhood knew me
as a man that loved God.
The entire neighborhood respected who I was and what I stood for. And so every night on my way home from altar call, back in the days we used to be at the altar and we used to sweat. Who remember those days? We used to worship and sweat until we were soaked. Remember, we would clap and clap all into the bank till our hand burst. Remember those days? And I remember I used to go home, and on my way home, every night I used to pass by a lady and her daughter. They were selling their wares from a little table at the corner of James Street and Southern Street, I think it was. And I used to stop and I used to witness to those people every single evening. They had a beautiful daughter. She had a beautiful daughter. And I remember the devil started to creep into my mind in a lustful fashion at that young lady. She was beautiful. Hallelujah. And I remember that while I witnessed to her, there was something inside of me that wanted to go another direction. And though I struggled with myself to do the right thing, David said, he needed to do the right thing, but the desire to do the wrong thing was stronger. And I remember one evening I went back from church and the young girl was not there. So I asked the mother, where is this young girl? She said she is sick. She has the flu and she's at home, which is across the street from where she was selling. My flesh became excited because now the flesh was telling me to go in and see her. But the Holy Spirit was telling me, no, do not go inside there. And I remember the Holy Spirit was pushing against me, telling me, no, do not go in there. But I began to lie to myself. While the Holy Spirit is part of me and said, no, don't go in there. I lied to myself. And I told myself that I was strong enough to go in there and pray to her. But on my consciousness, I knew that my flesh desired wrong. I'll be honest with you. And I went inside there, and the devil had his way. Hallelujah. I remember I walked out of that place feeling so defeated. I walked out there because I fell right in that room with that young lady. And there's something about pleasure of sin. There's something about the lust of the flesh. That lust of the flesh can be so strong. That desire to do wrong is so strong. But as soon as the devil has his way, you realize that it was all for nothing. As soon as that last bit of pleasure happened, I was in a dark place. A very, very, very dark place. And I walked out of there with my head in shame. And I walked home. And I knew right there and then that my life was now different because I allowed the devil to get in with me. I'm speaking to somebody right now who is telling yourself that is strong enough to go yourself in that room with that brother or that sister and like yourself that is strong enough. It's a lie from the pit of hell. It is a lie from the pit of hell. And you know it because if you have the Holy Spirit, that Holy Spirit will be telling you right now and then, no! Don't lie to yourself. I remember Pastor Stewart
brother. He says, come on, you know that when you go into that room with the opposite sex, someone you're attracted to, you know you need to go in there to, you see them one end of the bed and she's in the other end and you read newspaper. So, moving on, I felt so trapped because at this point I was scared to approach all the people. And I was one of those people that I could not go in and pretend that I was in the right place. I don't know how people do that. So I went to church and I couldn't worship. And I decided to tell somebody and they judged me. I knew nothing about grace. I read about grace. The preacher preached about grace. I never understood what grace meant. I didn't know that all I had to do at that point was fall on my knee and say, God, I'm sorry. The devil told me that God would not forgive me. The devil told me that I was now a filth before God. I never understood what grace was. The unmerited favor of God. Something that I couldn't purchase. Something that I could not purchase with my own good deeds. The song where it says grace, grace, God's grace. Grace that would pardon and cleanse within. Grace, grace, God's grace. Grace that is greater than all my sin. And when I became a police officer in my backslidden state, I did the most ruthless things. I did things that I never thought that I could have done to another human being. And as John Mark says, I can't tell you all of it, because if I tell you all of it, I'll implicate myself and a lot of things will go wrong with myself here in America. But if you know how God looked at for me, if only you know how God looked at for me. There are many times I stood before the gun with somebody else's trigger, a finger on the trigger, and they could not pull the trigger. God kept me. God kept me. God kept me. He hid me in the cleft of the rock and covered me with his hand. My survival was based on my skillfulness or me being smart. But I came to know now that it was only the grace of God. Only the grace of God. So speak of that person that is planning to step out of God. Don't do it. The Bible says the wages of sin is death. And by my experience, death doesn't necessarily mean a physical dying. It could mean the death of a dream. It could be the death of a hope. It could be the death of something that you prayed for that was waiting on the other side before you sin. Went to America. It should take all day, so a few shortcuts. Went to America. And from a police officer, I went to the other side of the law. God knows what I did. I became involved, I became a criminal, I did wrong things, and I got into the system. But all this time, Brother Martin, what I cannot understand is that in all my filth, the Holy Ghost never left. I could not understand it. Because every time I did something wrong, the Holy Spirit cursed me in my ways. What are you doing? It came to a point when I was doing wrong things that I felt like I want to physically throw up. That's how the Spirit deal with me. God never left me. In 30 years of my backslidden position, He never, ever, ever, ever left me. And I thought to myself, I didn't want to say that loud because I didn't want to become impertinent, but I said, I have to be special. I have to be special because God He doesn't want to leave me. And so, my criminality caught up with me. And the government put me into deportation proceedings. When I look back and I said, God, am I really going to go back to Jamaica? Am I going to leave my family and my business here and go back to Jamaica? I said, God, I'd rather commit suicide than go to the other suffer. I had to go face some of the people that I've hurt before I left. And that I was now used to a certain lifestyle that I couldn't see myself living below the lifestyle. But I said, God, deliver me. Deliver me. I said, God, I need to go to the courtroom and the judge says you're free to go. But God said to me, in order for me to give you that, you have to give me a sacrifice. Now, a sacrifice is not something that you just give up freely without any pressure. A sacrifice is something that you hold valid, important to you, that you really can't let go of, something of value. So I thought about a bunch of things that I keep God in a stage to hear and not guilty. And I came face to face with a certain thing and a certain habit that I had. I said, God, usually when I come to Jamaica, I look forward to this and that and this and that. I can't tell you what it is. I said, God, I'm prepared to give that to you. It took me months to say, God, take this from me. Take it. And I consciously said, God, here I am. Take it. I am yours. I walked into that courthouse. The judge said, Mr. Forman, you're free to go. By the mercies of God, I keep my time. But more than anything else, I'm encouraging all of you that's here. None of us are perfect. Back in the old days, we grew up thinking that you should be a perfect Christian, and if you do this or do that, God help you. God is merciful. Now, you can't fool God and pretend that you're doing the right thing when you know that you're not. But if you love God, if you feel if you have the Holy Spirit, you will naturally not want to do wrong, but the flesh will make you want to. That's natural. And even to this day, I still struggle with forgiving myself because I'm not perfect. But I'm reminded about the grace of God. I'm reminded about the grace of God. And if you're in that place today, and you fell along the way, and you have remained in that filth, in that gutter, even if you continue to fall in that gutter over and over and over again, the Bible said He's faithful and just to forgive you of your sins. Get up, rise up. Walk in holiness. There's a lot of things that I've been hearing before I came to Jamaica about Brother Jen Mark and how much the people has followed him and that people have stepped down from their standards of holiness. It's all over everywhere. But I say to the person, if you're filled with the Holy Spirit, John Mark has nothing to do with the Holy Spirit telling you that you should get out of that place. If you feel the Holy Spirit, you cannot lie in filth and do filth. Because the Holy Spirit is there to convict you to get out. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
God has done to me. Feel so undeserved. Yet he gave